Western Mumbai is developing at a fast rate. Thanks to strong government push, the city is trying to make the best amenities for its people, and this will change how citizens in Mumbai are living their lives in a positive way. The Mumbai Metro Project. It's being constructed with the aim to provide safe, reliable and comfortable rail-based mass transit systems to the people of Mumbai and to supplement the already existing Mumbai suburban rail system. Many pockets of the city are not served by the existing rail network. In addition to that, due to overcrowding, there are 12 to 15 deaths reported every single day. Because of this, there's been an exponential rise in private vehicles on the roads. This is what a metro station is going to look like, and to my Mumbai is a city that never sleeps. This was taken into consideration while planning and implementing the construction of the metro. Get this, Mumbai is the only city in the world that is constructing all metro lines simultaneously. Cities normally build 1 to 2 lines at a time. Moreover, not a single road has been shut while construction has taken place. And speaking of relief to traffic problems, the underground metro line is also underway at great speed. Today, Mumbai remains one of the most polluted cities due to the large number of vehicle population in the city.
The tracks are below, as you can see. There we go. Now, this project has about 450.
The MML 3, or the Mumbai Metro Line 3, will carry 17 lakh passengers every day. This means that this line alone will take 6.5 lakh vehicle trips off the road. The impact? At least 2.61 lakh tons of CO2 pollution will reduce each and every single year. Now, of course, there will still be vehicles on the road, and the state government is also taking action on how to make that better as well. The Mumbai Trans Harbour Link, or the MTHL. Aiming to decongest Mumbai, the MTHL is an under-construction road bridge that connects Mumbai with satellite city Navi Mumbai. Not only will this decongest multiple parts of the city, including traffic-heavy areas, it will also be connected to both the Mumbai-Pune Expressway and to the proposed Western Freeway. Which brings me to the most important part of infrastructure and development. Now that you've seen some of the cutting-edge projects that the government of Maharashtra is getting done, how does infrastructure and development progress in a positive and long-term manner? The answer? Involving young minds and innovation. The Chief Minister's Fellowship Program, launched 5 years ago under CM Devendra Fadnavis, aims to involve young graduates into administration. Selected fellows between 21 to 26 years old spend 11 months participating in policy making, execution, monitoring, and evaluation of programs. It's an incredibly selective program which selected this year 50 eligible fellows from over 6,000 applications after a test. The fellows come from diverse backgrounds into public affairs. Kaustubh Dhavse, OSD to the CM, who mentors the fellows and drives the fellowship program as well, says that the program is important for other reasons rather than just the experience and the network.
Please drop a like, leave a comment, share the videos, and don't forget to subscribe.